redfin bilways are really endangered here, and you know, we're at great risk of disappearing through interactions with the feral gambusia. And yes, we could lose them within a couple of years without the management that Bush Heritage is doing. Edgbaston Reserve is an amazing place. It's in the top end of the Lake Eyre catchment. It overlaps a number of regional ecosystems. We've got some desert uplands, we've got some mitchell grass downs, and in between the two we've got this amazing artesian spring complex. And we've got two species of fish, one of them's amongst the most endangered in the world, a little redfin blue eye, only occurs in the artesian springs on Edgbaston. The springs are outlets of the great artesian basin, natural outlets. The water comes from deep underground through natural fissures, and right up in the top of the catchment is about 100 artesian springs that are amongst the most unique places in the world. So redfin blue eye were discovered by Peter Unmack. I came and visited Edgbaston to make sure he had actually found something new and unique. And he had. It was amazing. What are fish doing out here in the desert, in shallow water, in tiny little springs? How did they get here? The big issue now is gambusia, the fish that's been introduced to Australia and has found its way into our springs. So one of our big plans is to provide gambusia exclusion fencing. We put some fences around the springs. They're just a low fence with a fine mesh. And the idea is that we protect the spring from gambusia travelling overland during rain. In the 90s, redfin blue eye were in 7 of the largest ones. Now, redfin blue eyes are in 1 of those 7 springs, and gambusia are now in 30 springs. We're fighting an uphill battle to keep our redfin blue eyes. We're undertaking a number of strategies to do that. So translocation is when we take some redfin blue eyes from a natural spring and we move them into one of our renovated springs. And we take some redfin blue eyes, about 50 odd, and we introduce them into the spring and watch them breed, which is fantastic. So now we have 6 populations like that, and we're about to have a whole bunch more. One of those strategies is trying to renovate the springs, and we're working at the moment on another 3 and perhaps a 4th one, the 4th spring that's going to be suitable for our translocated populations. But one of the other things we're trying to do is create some artificial springs. It obviously takes a long time to build a spring habitat, but we've got the structure, and within the next couple of months the vegetation will be well established and we'll introduce some more redfin blue eyes. So the new captive breeding strategy involves large poly tanks with a floating raft, and on that raft we've recreated the spring vegetation and the shallow habitat. We think that might be the secret to getting redfin blue eye to breed long term in captivity. Mind you, we've made some great achievements, some great progress in the last 10 or so years, and there's hope. So yes, I want the thing to survive. I desperately, desperately want redfin blue eyes to be here forever.